Hello everyone, welcome to Nelson School online education program Learn Better. So today we'll be beginning with active and passive voice. We'll be continuing with the active to passive transformation, but today we'll be seeing the continuous tense in past. So it's past continuous tense. In the previous session we have seen present continuous. Today we'll be doing past continuous. So past continuous active voice, it will have was and were as the helping verbs, and verb will be used in ing. The main form will be used in ing form, okay? But in passive, was and were will remain same or as per the need of the object, as we have done in the present continuous. This ing will be given to BEB, so it changes to being verb as it is necessity for it to come in its past participle form, okay? So in past, it will have past continuous tense. Active voice will have was and were plus verb ing. And in past, the passive voice, past continuous, the passive voice will have was and were plus being plus verb will be in its past participle form. Again, the recap of the subject and the object. I as a subject changes to me as the object. We as a subject changes to us as the object. You as the subject remains you as the object. He as a subject changes to him as the object. She as a subject changes to her as the object. It as a subject remains it as the object. They as a subject changes to them as an object. Contents for transforming active to passive voice, 8 subtenses. This is the 5th subtense we are going for, the past continuous tense. After that, we'll be having the imperative sentences. And finally, using modals and the sentences beginning with let. 2 methods as we have learned till now. First is to have the assertive sentences transformation and the interrogative sentences transformation. Assertive sentences will be seeing the transformation of active to passive of affirmative sentences and transformation of active to passive of negative sentences. We shall learn both the tenses for each subtense mentioned: negative, affirmative and interrogative. Let us begin with the continuous tenses, and that will today do past continuous tense. Active to passive past continuous tense, affirmative sentence, the active voice formula will be: she was writing a letter. Subject was and were, verb will be having ing and then object. But in passive voice, object shall be brought ahead. Okay, was and were will be used same. ing will be given to being and verb will come in its third form. And finally, the subject. Rules to convert active to passive, past continuous, affirmative. First, I'll read the rules. Box the subject, underline the verb and circle the object as usual. Bring the object at the beginning, second step. Add was and were. After that, you have to add being, being, and immediately the verb in its third form. Number 4, add by, by. Number 5, take the subject at the end. Let us begin and put all these rules into practice. We were talking about Francis. Okay, so we is the subject. You have to put a square. Okay, were talking is the verb, so you have to underline it. About is the preposition that follows the verb, and it would follow the verb in passive voice also. Francis is the object, so we have to circle it. Second step is to bring the object at the beginning, so you have to bring Francis at the beginning. Because it was we, verb was used, now it is Francis, so was will be used. Now third step, give ing, so it changes to being. Then third form of the verb, talk, talked, talked. Because preposition is there, so it will follow the verb. Fine. Add fourth step, by, by, and bring the subject at the last, that is us. We changes to us. So it sounds Francis was being talked about by us. Number 2, I was repairing their bikes. So I is the subject, you have to put a box. Was repairing is the verb, so we have to underline it. Their bikes is the object, so we have to circle it. Now in number 2, bring the object at the beginning. So their bikes, I'll bring it at the beginning. Because it was I, so was used. Now it is their bikes, plural, so I'll be using were. Now give ing to be, so it becomes being. verb into its third form immediately beside that. So it is repair, repaired, repaired. Okay, add by, by, that is added, and then take the subject at the end, that is me. So it sounds, their bikes were being repaired by me. Rules to convert active to passive affirmative sentences continuation. She was watching a film. So she is the subject, put a box. Was watching is the verb, so we have to underline it. A film is the object, so we have to circle it. Now bring the object at the beginning. So a film is brought at the beginning. Because it is singular, so I'll be using was as it is. Give ing to beb, so it becomes being. Okay, then watch, the third form of the verb, watch, watched, watched, that will be using. Fourth step, add by, by, so I've added by, by. And fifth step, to take the subject at the last, so she changes to her. So it sounds, a film was being watched by her. Number four, he was playing the guitar. He is the subject, so put a box. Was playing is the verb, underline it. The guitar is the object, so circle it. Okay, bring the object ahead, the guitar. As it is singular, was only will be used. Okay, the third step, give ing to beb, so it changes to being. Third form of the verb immediately beside being, so it is play, played, played. Add by, by, fourth step, and take the subject at the last, so he changes to him. It sounds, the guitar was being played by him. Active to passive past continuous tense with the negative sentences. Now it will have active voice, will have she as a subject. She was not writing a letter, that is subject, then was a verb, then not, negative word will be used immediately after helping verb, then verb in its ing form, and finally the object. Passive voice will be the object to be brought ahead. Use was and were immediately after helping verb, put not. Give ing to be, so it changes to being. Bring the verb into its third form. Add by, by, and take the subject at the end. This we'll see practically with the rules and even the examples. Now, rules to convert active to passive past continuous negative sentences. I'll first read the rules and then we'll put them into the practice step by step. Number one, box the subject, underline the verb and circle the object. Number two, bring the object at the beginning. Number three, add was and were as per the need. Immediately after that, add negative word not. Then take the ing from the verb, so it becomes being. And immediately beside it, the verb in its third form or V3. Add by, by, take the subject at the end. So let us put these steps into practice. Number one, you were not painting the gate. So it is you is the subject, so put a box. Were painting is the verb, so we have to underline. The gate is the object, so I have to circle it. Now bring the gate ahead, okay? Because it was you, so were was used. It is gate, so was will be used, fine? Now bring down not, the negative word. Third step, give ing, so it changes to being. Immediately beside that, put the third form, that is paint, painted, painted. Add by, and take the subject at the last, so you remains you. So it will be, the gate was not being painted by you. Number two, she was not driving him home. She is the subject, so put a box. Was driving is the verb, so underline it. Him is the object, so we have to circle it. Now bring this object ahead, so while coming ahead, him will change to he. Okay, again it's singular, so was only will be used. Immediately after helping verb, put negative word not. Third step, take ing down, so it changes to being. Immediately beside that, V3, so it is drive, drove, driven. Fine, add by, and then her. But this extra word home is there, so we have to put, that is, he was not being driven home by her. Number three, he was not feeding the dogs. So he is the subject, box it. Was feeding is the verb, underline it. The dogs is the object, so we have to circle it. Now bring the object ahead, the dogs. It was he, so they have used was. It is the dog, so I'll be using were, because dogs plural, so I'll be using were. Immediately put the not down, give ing to be, so it becomes being. And then third form of the verb, feed, fed, fed. Okay, add by, by, and bring the subject down, so it changes to him. The answer will be, the dogs were not being fed by him. Number four, they were not eating the pudding. They is the subject, so put a box. Were eating is the verb, so underline it. The pudding is the object, so we have to circle it. Now bring the object ahead, the pudding. Okay, because it was they, were was used, it is pudding, so I'll be using was. Bring the negative word down, give ing to beb, so it changes to being. Immediately change the verb into its third form, v3, eat, ate, eaten. So it is eaten, add by, by, so I have added, and take the subject at the last, so it is they changes to them. So it sounds, the pudding was not being eaten by them. Active to passive, past continuous tense, interrogative statements. Okay, children, as we know that there are two kinds of interrogative statements, usually two kinds. The one is the WH, the other one is the inversion. WH needs the answer in detail, while as the helping verbs need the answer, inversion questions need the answer either yes or no. Fine. Now, in WH, there could be two types of questions asked. So it is who, then there will be subject will be missing. If it is other WH, then you could have the subject. In passive voice, it will be WH will be brought down same. And as I've taught you, WH is with the best friend with helping verbs. Then put the object. BEB form and V3 form are the best friends. Children, now onwards, will have two pairs, as I've taught you in present continuous also. WH and helping verb, first pair, then object, then BE form and V3, second pair, then BY by and subject. In the case of inversion questions, where the question starts from helping verbs, that is was or were, we have to double underline it and will be used same. Was will be brought down same, were also will be brought down same. Now object is to be brought here, then give ing here, immediately beside it put the verb into its third form, add by, by, and take the subject at the last. Do not forget to put the interrogation mark, as it is the transformation of interrogative statements. Now, rules for changing active to passive interrogative sentences. Box the subject, underline the verb, and circle the object. Use triangle to highlight the question words like who, whose, whom, which, what, when, where, how, etc. Double underline the helping verbs, that is was and were. Begin the passive voice either with the question word or with the helping verb as it is required. Use the verbs was and were after the question words. Bring the object ahead. After bringing the object ahead, put being being and the action verb beside it. And then as usual, write by, by, and take the subject at the last. So number one, why were you riding the horse? So it is you is the subject, box it. Were riding is the verb, underline it. The horse is the object, we have to circle. Now WH question is there, so I'll put a triangle and bring it down same. WH, beside WH, there should be a helping verb as they are the best friends. It was you, so were was used. Now horse is going to be brought ahead, so was will be used. Okay. Now WH and helping verb, the pair, then the object, the horse. Give ing to be, so it changes to being. Third form of the verb ride, that changes to ride, rode, rode. Add by, by. And finally take the subject at the last. So it sounds, why was the horse being rode by you? Number two, when was he giving you the article? So it is he, subject, was giving you verb, was giving verb. U is the object, so circulate. WH, so you have to triangle and bring down, same. It was he, so was used. Now you are going to bring you ahead, so what you'll be using? Were. Okay, so the pair, when, for, WH plus helping verb. Okay, now bring the object ahead, you. Give ing down, so it changes to being. Take the third form of the verb, V3, so it is give, gave, given. Now the extra word, the article. Finally add by, by, and take the subject at the last, so it becomes him. So the answer would be, when were you being given the article by him? Number 3, was she reading these lines? She is the subject, box it. Was reading is the verb, underline it. These lines is the object, so you have to circle it. Okay, now it is an interrogative statement, beginning with the inversion questions are there. So was will be brought down, same, but do keep it in mind, it was she, so was used. You are going to bring these lines ahead, so were will be used. Okay, were these lines, give ing down, so it becomes being. Now give the third form of the verb, read, read, read. Add by, by. Okay, so I've added by, by, and take the subject at the last, so she changes to her. So it sounds, were these lines being read by her? Number 4, were they carrying the bag? So it is they is the subject, box it. Were carrying is the verb, underline it. The bag is the object, circle it. Now, we have to, it is an inversion question. Because it was they, so were was used. You are going to bring the bag ahead. So what we'll be using? Was. Was the bag. Okay. Now ing, give it down. So it changes to being. And third form of the verb, carry, carried, carried. Then add by, by. Finally take the subject last. So it changes to them. So it sounds, was the bag being carried by them? This is the worksheet, children. As we usually do it, you have to do it in the rough notebook. It is a mixed sort of exercise of interrogative, affirmative and negative. You have to solve it in your rough book. The solution to this worksheet will be given in the next session in both the forms. Thank you.